bright suns, travelers, and welcome to my video. Okay, so I'm, for those of you who don't know who I am, which is everybody, my name is Skywalker-Ren, or, okay, my last name's really not Ren, but you get the point. But, I'm also known as Rey Skywalker-Ren on Sonic Stadium. That's a little bit of history for you guys. But I've done talking stuffs before, so yeah. Why am I doing this? Why am I responding to sonic93 when everybody else has done the same thing? Well, here's the thing. I used to kind of be like sonic93, especially on Sonic Stadium. You know, I used to be a really, really big passionate fan of Sonic the Hedgehog, to the point where it kind of clouded my judgment, like how I was arguing, and I got in a lot of trouble for that. And when I watch sonic93's videos and how she interacts with people, especially about her favorite characters, I kind of see a lot of how I used to be in her, and I decided that I don't want her going down the same path as I did and losing all my friends and all that stuff. So I'm here to make a video to help her. Now, like I said, I want to do is help. It may not, you know, be useful. However, you know, it kind of pains me to see somebody go down the same rabbit hole that I once was. I mean, at least I got all my friends back because I learned from my mistakes. I had to learn the hard way. And I'm pretty sure that sonic93 is going to have to learn the hard way as well. So, without further ado, let's get into the video.
Hey guys!
Bright suns!
This is sonic93 here with a very, 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 very important video!
Okay, I don't understand why this video is important, but I guess we will get to that, right? Right?
This is regarding from what happened a year ago, where I made a video called sonic93 is not amused with the sooo fanbase. And I got a lot of hate for that, and it caused a lot of controversy.
I mean, you got a lot of hate for that video for a reason. I mean, the reason why you got a lot of hate for that video is because it seemed like you were kind of stuck offish, you know, like those snobby girls in high school. Yeah, it kind of seemed like you were getting on people because they didn't like Silver the way that you liked him. And people had a very, very not so good reaction to that. Yeah. I'm not going to say gatekeeping because I know you don't know what that word is. However, it kind of seems like you were going out of your way to attack this person for not liking Silver the way you think they should like him.
And before I continue, yes, I am fully aware that the audio sounds incredibly echoey and I apologize for that. It's because I've been moving into a new place and I haven't been able to sell things just yet. It's been very stressful for the past 2-3 weeks. And so far, I haven't even unpacked my stuffs. So yeah, I hope you guys can have mercy on me on why it's so echoey. And I hope it's not too distracting to listen to what I have to say in this video, because it's really important.
I think your audio sounds just fine to me. I mean, I'm not hearing any echoes. But then again, I'm not an expert on tech stuff. You know, I'm just a Star Wars fan, but I don't see anything wrong with your echo or any your audio issues. I actually think your audio is better than mine, because I don't know, I'm trying to work this mic and you can hear me breathing, and I know that's going to be annoying, but I can't help it, so yeah.
Anyways, back to the video. Now you might wonder, why am I making a video about it when a topic died and I already apologized for it?
Says everybody that was watching this video. Okay, so the rest of the video was just her talking about how some of her friends didn't support her and she felt that she was unheard, and then introductions from other people that I kind of don't care about. I'm not trying to be mean, no disrespect to them, because I mean, I respect everybody, but they're not really relevant to this video. I mean, they're kind of are, but I'm not gonna respond to somebody's introduction because they're just making an introduction. So we're gonna skip ahead to the further parts.
She did nothing wrong. You should have censored her. You're bullying her. You're becoming what you ranted about, etc., etc.
I mean, maybe that's what you were actually doing. That's why people called you out on it. I mean, think about it. I mean, you got on this girl because she didn't like Silver the Hedgehog the way you think that she should like her. I mean, we're gonna get to this in a minute, but a little bit of a spoiler alert. Sonic93, kind of gets on her about how this person wants Silver to be like a different way, and she's like, "Well, how do you want him to act?" And my question to Sonic93 is, "How do you want her to like Silver?" Like, that is something that I generally want to know. Maybe I think I said that wrong. Genuinely, yeah, genuinely, that's what I want to know. Like, how do you want this person to like Silver? Like, I want to know. Yeah, but as for bullying, when I watched your video before it got deleted, you were saying some pretty nasty things to this girl because you didn't like her opinions. You were saying things like, "What the beep is wrong with you? Are you serious? You're supposed to be a Silver fangirl," and you were like mocking this person. You were even mocking them for their grammar, which I have to say, your grammar, her grammar, no disrespect to Sonic93, but I thought her grammar was better than yours. But English was her first language and English is not yours, so I'm not judging because English is not my first language either. But you kind of got petty to where you were making fun of her grammar and the way she speaks, all because you didn't like her opinion. So yeah, you were kind of bullying this girl. So yeah, those people were right to say that.
So here's the thing. I never claimed that you shouldn't see flaws of your favorite character. I never said that you should like Silver the way I like him. And I absolutely never said that you have to accept everything a character does.
Okay, so you may have not outright said those things, but you most certainly implied it to the point where people were making rants on you. I mean, that's the implication that I got when I watched the video. I mean, and also, spoiler alert, you did get on Alduin in your other rant video about how you said something to the tune of, that's what you got yourself into when liking this character, when Alduin was talking about flaws and all that stuff. Like, you basically were telling her that when Alduin said that she didn't like how her favorite character was a murderer or something, that that's what she got into. Basically, you're kind of blaming her for liking a murderer as like her favorite character. That's the implication that I got, and you kind of outright said it in your video about her. But yeah, that last point, spoiler alert, you actually said it. You actually said it. Like, you actually implied that you have to accept everything that the character does, which you don't have to. My favorite character is Kylo Ren, but I don't like how he ordered all the stormtroopers to shoot all the villagers. Yeah, I don't. But as for not liking Silver the way you do, you most certainly implied that by your foaming of the mouth about Melody not about her points, were some of her points a little dumb? Yeah, but it's her opinion. She's allowed to express whatever she wants, and you were kind of foaming at the mouth with that. So yeah, you did imply that she, you know, because she didn't like Silver the way you did, she's not a Silver fan.
All I was doing is getting incredibly upset over Melody's confusing arguments and opinions towards Silver that didn't make any sense and had too much to complain about his character rather than liking his character.
I mean, that list was a list of flaws about the character. Those were things that she didn't like about the character. You know, she wrote an essay explaining all the things she didn't like about Silver, and it kind of made sense, because even though she did kind of say, oh, Silver is one of my favorite characters because I like his naivety, he's so cute, blah 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 blah, but her essay was mostly about Silver's flaws, not what she liked about the character.
Because, really? Why calling yourself a huge fan of a character when you're focusing way too much negative things about him rather than the positive things about him?
Just as an FYI, my friend, you can still be a fan of a character and complain about how the character is portrayed or something, or write an essay about mostly about the character's flaws and what can be fixed. I mean, just because you're a fan of a character doesn't mean you have to like every single thing about the damn character. Like, for example, my favorite character is Kylo Ren. Do I like everything about Kylo Ren? No! If you ask me, okay, Miyoko, what don't you like about Kylo Ren? I will give you a whole list about everything I don't like about Kylo Ren. It will fill up a 2x5 postcard front and back. But it doesn't mean that I'm not a fan of Kylo Ren. I'm still a really big fan of him. But yeah, you make it sound like, you know, if you write about everything that you don't like about the character, then you're automatically not a fan. Which I can understand why you would think that. You know, I understand, because if you write negative, it automatically thinks that you don't like the character. But people need to understand that, you know, you can still be a fan of a character and still complain about them. That's the whole point of this essay, was to expand on Silver's flaws and what she didn't like about the character and what could be changed. That's all.
And you might say now, oh, well, maybe Melody just complains about how Silver's written in the Sonic games, not as a character himself. Now, I get that. I can totally understand that. I've done the same thing with Amy from Sonic Boom. She's my favorite female character, but I hate how she's written in the show. She's a completely different character from the original that I cannot stand her, and I honestly want her to die and burn in hell.
Oh, don't be hating on my girl, Amy. I see you, Sonic93. I'm just messing with you, Sonic93. But you get my point, right? So, I'm gonna skip ahead a little bit because it was just her talking about how Melody doesn't understand Silver's personality and how her not liking Silver's flaws is different than her not liking Boom Amy and Twilight, and talks about some artist picture, you know, blah 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 stuff that I don't really care about.
My problem was, and still is, that the guy I talked about claims that Silver is his favorite character and want him to have his own game, which I also want, obviously. Yet, complains how Silver was written in Sonic 06, aka Silver's personality in every single Sonic game, more or less.
Excuse me, Miss Sonic93. You do understand that that guy's video was about critiquing Sonic? The video wasn't about what he liked about Silver. It was about critiquing Sonic. It was about critiquing Sonic games. I mean, I'm pretty sure that he likes a lot of the characters. However, the video was about critiquing Sonic. Like, girl, Of course he's gonna critique Silver's character because he was critiquing Sonic 06 and critiquing Sonic games in general and how the characters were written. Like, come on.
Just like, why are you calling him your favorite character if you can't accept his personality? That makes no sense.
Please refer to my earlier points about how you can be a fan of any character and still critique them. Because, girl, I am not repeating myself. And yeah, I'm gonna skip some of this video because it's just her repeating the same thing over and over again about how this guy, why is Silver your favorite character when you would say, you don't like him, blah 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 blah. And all I can say to that is, please refer to my last point in this video because, like I told you, I am not repeating myself. I'm sorry. I'm just not. So, most of this stuff I'm kind of going to skip over because you'll find that Sonic93 likes to repeat herself a lot. Like, she does.
I'm personally a huge Silver fan, and there's a lot of things that I love about the character, like his cuteness, his innocent, naively optimistic. I have the state of war personality. I also really love how.
She literally repeats how.
See what I'm talking about, y'all? Like, they like to point at her grammar mistakes. And by the way, Mr. Sprite dude, have you ever heard of a typo? I mean, maybe Melody typed this on her iPad or her iPhone. I mean, the iPad and the iPhone are kind of notorious for repeating words and typos, especially if, you're typing and you're voicing your typing through Siri. Yeah, she is not your best friend when it comes to that. But yeah. Oh, and another piece of advice for you guys. You really need to take dramatic reading classes because your dramatic reading sounds like nails on a chalkboard. No disrespect to you guys, but I'm just saying. But I'm gonna skip over some of this because basically their points are just points that I can respond to flawlessly with my other points, so I don't really want to repeat myself. So, enjoy the Kylo Ren.
Hate is a strong opposite word of love. And when you say you love something and then hate at the same time, that just goes against your logic.
Let me see if this will help you. I love Kylo Ren, but I hate how he can fly off at the edge of a penny, a drop of a penny, he flies into a rage. He can pick a fight with the sidewalk. I love Kylo Ren, but I do hate how he ordered the stormtroopers to kill innocent villagers. I mean, does that make sense to you? Like, you can love a character but hate some of the things they do. I mean, I hope this really helps because I feel like I repeated this a couple of times, but I really want you to understand where I'm coming from.
Now for this point and my thoughts on it. Here we go. I hate his immature voice portrayed in Sonic 2006. To have a likable character, they have to be portrayed well, and to be honest, Silver was portrayed as annoying, whiny, but acting like he's all serious when he's around Sonic or Shadow. First off, while she may be entitled to think his voice is immature, annoying, and whiny, she should know that Silver is 14 years old. So he's younger than Sonic, who is 15, and Shadow, who although is established to be over 50, at least chronologically, looks to be around close to Sonic's age group. Even Blaze, while she is the same age as Silver, she is older than him maturely. Second, for his serious attitude in Sonic 06, he was battling Sonic and then later on Shadow. And not to be so nitpicky on the grammar, but she misspelled immature as immature with an N.
Alright, so if we're not being nitpicky on the grammar, why bring it up? And by the way, like I told the last person, have you ever heard of a typo? Because they exist. But anyway, on to the points. So I kind of do agree with Melody that in order to have a good character, they have to be well written. And I'll be honest with you, I'm a Silver fan, and even I kind of think that Silver in Sonic 06 wasn't portrayed as well as the writers, as their, the goal. I think they missed the goal with Silver, in my general opinion. I mean, I liked him, but the overall goal wasn't the finished product, in my general opinion. And as for her point about how he should be serious, well, he was actually supposed to be set up as the, you know, the savior of the future, but instead they made him sound like a whiny kid who, yeah. I mean, I understand, yeah, he's 14, but, you know, just because a character is young doesn't mean they have to have an annoying voice. But then again, I mean, think about what Marine sounds like. She probably sounds like a really hyperactive... I don't even want to think about it. But yeah. Even though I had no problem with Silver's voice, I can understand why a lot of people do. Like, I do.
How is Silver not a character to be taken seriously? Just because he sounds a certain way or behaves a certain way? Have you ever thought of how powerful Silver is and can easily defeat anyone with his psychokinesis? I mean, he kept getting in Sonic's way twice in the game, and Sonic would be pretty much dead if Shadow didn't step in to save him. So, like, how exactly do you want him to act, like, to consider him as a serious character?
Also, maybe it's just my interpretation, but I didn't think Melody was talking about Silver's actual powers and, you know, how he can slam people with his psychokinesis. She was talking about how the character was built up to be a serious character like Shadow, but he didn't come across, with the voice, he didn't come across that way. Melody never said that Silver wasn't a serious character. It's that he wasn't portrayed as one, as he was. The voice and the character himself and his mannerisms don't compute with each other. Maybe I'm wrong. I will be glad to admit that I'm wrong. But I don't think that Melody was saying that Silver wasn't powerful and all that stuff. She was saying that, you know, it doesn't make sense how this character is built up to be the savior of the future, the one to stop Iblis. However, he sounds like a whiny little kid. That's exactly what she's saying. And that's her opinion. And it does make sense because a lot of other people hold this opinion too.
Welcome everyone. It's my turn to read Melody's stupid points that make absolutely no sense whatsoever.
Ow, the edge!
I find it silly when he says, if I eliminate that guy, will our world be saved? Silver, in my opinion, lacks critical thinking and believes anything people tell him without a question or finding out the information is actual, especially coming from a hedgehog with snake eyes and no mouth. Yes, Melody, because a character's appearance slash looks totally confirms whether they're good or bad. It's totally not like there's any good guys that look evil or anything. Shadow. Omega. Freaking Hellboy!
Wow, I mean, y'all like to talk about how Melody is misinterpreting Silver's personality, but here y'all here, like, misinterpreting her points. Like, Melody never said that Silver was supposed to be evil or something like that. Yeah, all Melody said was that, you know, he's pretty gullible for just believing anything anyone tells him, which is true. I mean, yeah, Silver was desperate to save the future. However, you know, people have a right to critique that because, you know, you can't just believe things that everybody says. I mean, he just believed anything Mephiles told him to do and didn't even, like, ask him. I mean, he asked him, like, once, like, tell me, who is the Iblis Trigger? And Mephiles just said something and Silver just goes along with it. Like, it took him to, like, towards the end of the game to realize Sonic was not the Iblis Trigger and Mephiles is, like, just jerking him around. But seriously, that is a valid critique, guys. He literally did not question Mephiles or anybody else.
from my original video, if you really think that Silver lacks critical thinking and believe anything people tell him without questioning them, what's your argument on Knuckles, who have been tricked more than once by the same person?
Because the video or the frickin' passage was not about beeping Knuckles. I'm sure she thinks Knuckles is a hothead. He's known to be a hothead. However, the post was about Silver, not Knuckles.
Blaze didn't question Mephiles either. Blaze literally said nothing against him and went along with it as well. Seriously, why are no one saying anything about that and act like Silver's the only one in the wrong and had no reason to believe in Mephiles? I mean, you even said it yourself that Blaze believed in him. So why is no one saying anything about that? Oh, I know. Because Blaze is a better character than Silver. And Silver had a bad debut, so he's automatically a dumbass. Even though someone else did the same thing. But I'm not gonna say anything about it because hashtag all hail Blaze, the queen and the best of all Sonic Field character!
First off, why are you yelling? Seriously, why are we yelling? And you complain that people were complaining that you were yelling in your last video, but you do more of that in this video, spoiler alert. But seriously, why are we getting ourselves worked up? And like I said, this post was about Silver, not Blaze. But seriously, Sonic93. You need to calm down. This is why people were ranting on you. Because you're so passionate about Silver, it clouds your freaking judgment. I was the exact same way when it came to Sonic. Sonic was my favorite Sonic character. And I would get upset that people would say things about him and like try to critique him or something like that. I was the exact same way as you. And I see a lot of the traits that I used to have in this video. Like, I am, like, really worried. Like, you really need to calm down and take a step back. That's all I have to say.
I'm gonna give my two cents on that matter, too. I'm a huge Blaze fanboy, but even I'm annoyed by how there are people in the fanbase who treat her like she is the best thing in the Sonic franchise.
I wasn't originally going to respond to this, but I do want to put my two cents in. I do agree with Draco that it is kind of annoying that some Blaze fans think that she's the best thing that's ever happened in this franchise. And that was kind of why, like, in the past, I kind of disliked her. Because it's okay to think that Blaze is a good character, but I found it annoying that while doing that, they put all the other Sonic female characters down. Like, just because the other Sonic female characters are not like Blaze doesn't mean that they're weaklings. Like, they're not. Like, they would say something about how, like, Amy always gets kidnapped when the last game she ever got kidnapped was Sonic Adventure 1. And, yeah, Sonic didn't actually rescue her. And then they talk about how, like, oh, she doesn't show her cleavage. And, like, girl. First of all, just because Blaze is not running after Sonic and doing all this doesn't mean she's a strong female character. Well, she is. But it doesn't mean the other female characters aren't strong characters too. They are. We've had strong female characters way before Blaze came. But people act like she's the only strong female character in the Sonic franchise. That's what kind of annoyed me in the past. I mean, now I really like her now, but that's just my general opinion.
On top of that, I hate how when he was separated from Blaze, he was shouting Blaze like he couldn't be alone without her. As stated by Blaze herself, that Silver is insecure. Why being alone? I just find that a little annoying, especially from a hedgehog that's supposed to look cool and act all serious like Shadow when it's available. First of all, Melody, anyone can be insecure and still be cool. Also, you can't just like a character's personality, then immediately want to change it. And secondly,
Just because Shadow and Silver are both hedgehogs, they doesn't mean they both have to be cool.
Okay, now, I will agree that Melody's point about how Silver was panicking that he couldn't find Blaze not automatically, but seems annoying. I don't know. Maybe Melody finds insecure people annoying. And she likes, not people, characters, my bad. Maybe she finds insecure characters annoying, or characters that are not meant to be insecure annoying. That's her opinion. I mean, she's allowed to express it. I do disagree with her that, you know, being panicked doesn't make you annoyed. It's just part of the character. However, going back to this guy's point, I do want to point out that, one, Melody never said that just because Silver was a hedgehog, he had to be cool. That is not what she said at all. All she said in the last part was that it was weird coming from a hedgehog that's supposed to be cool like Shadow. You know, I bet you anything, even if Silver was a platypus, she would still have the same opinion. So no, it has nothing to do with him being a hedgehog. And yeah, yes, insecure people can be cool, but there are people that do not like insecure people or characters. I mean, trust me. I mean, I would know, because a lot of times I'm not fully confident and it annoys a lot of people. You know, that's just the kind of person that they are. And they have every right to like and dislike what they want. So I'm going to skip over this part because some of the points that they make is really repetitive and it doesn't really need responding to. Plus, Sonic 93's dramatic reading sounds like nails on a chalkboard. And then the grammar nitpicking and all that stuff. You get what I mean, right?
I don't need to play a game to give my own points if I can just easily look it up on YouTube. I'm just saying.
Well, that may be kind of true, but there is a difference between watching a cutscene on YouTube and actually experiencing the game for yourself via a console or a platform. You know, like, for example, you know, there was a point in time where when I first saw Sonic 06 on YouTube, like, I was like, I want to get Sonic. I want to get this game. But when I experience the game, it's a different feeling. I mean, yeah, I still like Sonic 06. Don't come after me. But the game was a little clunkier than what I expected when I saw it on YouTube. So, yeah, there is a difference between, you know, seeing a game on YouTube and actually experiencing the game. I'm just saying.
Why are you saying at first that he lacks critical thinking or believing in Mephiles when he was desperate to save the future, but in Rivals, where everyone are fucking competitive to achieve their goals and have a similar attitude as Silver, he's selfish and arrogant just to get to his goal first?
Alright, now, like I said in the beginning of the video, kind of, I am a Silver fan too. Silver is actually my third favorite Sonic character, but I will admit, A, everyone in Sonic Rivals was a little bit of a beephole, if you know what I mean. And two, you know, Silver is no different. He was very arrogant and very selfish in the beginning of the game. And then he kind of saw that, you know, maybe that's not the way to go. But yes, Sonic 93, Silver was selfish and arrogant in Sonic Rivals. And I don't really understand how, you know, your love of a character, you know, can overshadow, you know, everything else. Like, not overshadow everything else. It's like you can't even see that Silver has flaws, just like any other character. And then when somebody points out those flaws and that you don't agree with them, you get really upset. You know, like I said before, this is how I was with Sonic. I mean, there were points that I would talk about Sonic the Hedgehog, like the character, and defend him. Like, there was a point in time on Sonic Stadium that I wanted Sonic to have his very own game. Like, I didn't want, like, Sonic, the other Sonic characters around. I wanted Sonic to save the world by himself because I thought that the other characters were kind of ruining Sonic's debut. That was just my opinion in the past. And yeah, I mean, I was a very big hypocrite back then, and I see a lot of myself here in this video. But yeah, just so in Sonic Rivals, he was selfish and arrogant. He was, insulting people and talking down to them, for his goal. He didn't care what who got in his way or anything. And she has every right to think that's annoying. Did everybody do that in Sonic Rivals? Well, yes and no. I mean, yeah, Sonic kind of did that, but he was like kind of low down about it. And Shadow, was just being Shadow, of course. Knuckles, yeah. But yeah, I don't understand how it's difficult to see the flaws of your favorite character.
But I gotta ask, what exactly did Silver do to Sonic that bothers you that much to say that you agree with Sonic that Silver's getting on your nerves as well?
I don't know, maybe pop up at random times, be rude as heck to Sonic when Sonic was just trying to help or be on a mission or just wanted to know who he was. If somebody just popped up everywhere I went and was like totally rude to me, I would be really annoyed too. And Silver's one of my favorite characters.
I'm not gonna say that Silver's perfect in any way, nor do I want him to be. But you treat the littlest things he does like it's hate-worthy. His voice, his personality, and you have all these demands on how you want him to be like.
I don't know, man. I'm not sure if you've been on the internet a lot, but those are the common complaints that a lot of Sonic fans have about Silver. His personality, his voice, and how he was written in the game. Those are really common complaints. What Melody put is like popular complaints about Silver. Okay, maybe some of the points and how she said it was kind of weird, but those are common complaints.
There's a lot I have to say about this point, 'cause she fails so badly. I also hated how he even treated poor Tails when Tails collected rings for Shadow and Rouge, and Silver just comes in and says,
Thanks,
"Thanks,
Half Pint.
Half-Pint, I
I'll
will
take
take those
those
now."
now.
And poor Tails was sad because a bully stole his rings for no reason. We all make mistakes, but Silver didn't even have the nerve to at least apologize. Now, although I don't have Sonic Rivals, I've seen the cutscenes, and Silver was by no means a bully towards Tails. While he may have called him Half-Pint, he didn't mean it in an insulting way. It's just another word used to call kids.
No disrespect to you, Mr. Treacle Charizard, but I'm wondering if, like Sonic 93, you can't actually see the flaw of a character or recognize when a character is doing a wrongdoing. I don't know, because I don't know what if I hear Half Pint, I think of it as an insult, especially in a game like Sonic Rivals, when everybody insulting each other. Silver is no different. So when Silver says, "I'll take those Half Pint," it is meant to put him down. It's not meant as a, like a lighthearted joke or, "Oh, hey Half Pint, what's up, bro?" No, it's meant to put somebody down, and it's meant it is certainly meant as an insult. I just don't understand why you guys can't see it. I mean, I understand the characters are competitive, but wow. And also, when it comes to him stealing rings, okay, he may not have been maybe a bully. Maybe a bully is a little bit of a stretch, but the thing is that Tails is a nice guy. I mean, I don't think he would actually hesitate to give Silver some rings if he asked politely. I mean, like a normal person. But at the same time, these are fictional characters, and sometimes manners don't apply. Yeah. Alrighty, so I'm gonna skip over a big chunk of some of this because, yeah, some of the points were repetitive. Let's talk about Sonic Rivals and how Melody is saying the same thing about other characters, and And Melody sounds like a hater because she likes more things about, dislikes more things about Silver than likes. And, you know, apparently only liking a character for her looks is shallow, even though people can like characters however they want. And yeah, we're gonna try to skip over all this and we're gonna fast forward right now.
Because my first intention was to not say a word until the drama quiets down, because I knew if I made a sound, I would make things worse for myself.
Like you're making things worse for yourself now! By not being quiet and accepting, one, that you made an apology, and two, that you were wrong!
Also that I knew in the beginning that even if I did apologize, there will always be people who won't believe in you, no matter how sincere you are.
Well, I will admit that sometimes people doubt the sincerity of an apology, but a while back when I looked at the comments on your apology video, most of the comments were being very sincere and supportive. You know, people were like, good on you for apologizing, you know, you're growing for this, da 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 da. I mean, nowadays it doesn't seem like you are, but that's what most of the comments on your apology video were saying. It seems like you've learned nothing from it, and that's really sad. You know, that's really annoying. Not some 15-year-old girl on the internet thinking that a fictional character's voice is annoying. No, that's not the annoying part.
Ranging to her talking about how she hates how Silver looks like, to EVM wanting him off Sega. If that doesn't scream over-the-top hate, I don't know what does.
Wait, whoa. Bibbidi-bobbidi, back it up. Are you telling me that Melody now hates Silver? I wonder why that is. Maybe it's because of your video. You know, you exposed her name. People went after her. You know, everybody got on her about her opinion and kept asking her. She got so annoyed. And she probably thinks that, you know, because I don't like Silver the way this girl does, I probably might as well hate him. You know, and I'll be honest with you, I don't blame her. Like, I don't at all. Like, your video, you know, drove her away from your favorite character. So, nice job trying to prove a point, I guess?
That's a Silver fan, by the way. Sarcasm.
What kind of fan says that?
Guys? In case you guys haven't noticed, most of Melody's comments about wanting Silver out of the games and all that stuff happened after Sonic93's video about not being amused with the Silver fanbase. So, I'm really confused as to why you guys can't put two and two together. You know, Melody was a fan of Silver until Sonic93 and her huge platform decides to come in, complain about this girl, yell at this girl for having a different opinion on Silver. People start attacking this girl and asking her a bunch of questions. Girl gets annoyed and she starts hating Silver and she starts acting like a little troll just to get a rise out of said person that, you know, was the cause of all this drama. I mean, can't you put two and two together? Melody is not a fan of Silver anymore. And it is Sonic93's fault.
I mean, she recently even made a fucking petition for Sega to get rid of Silver, both with Amino and DA. She even freaking wrote them a message on Tumblr and acts like all her points are fucking facts.
Like you!
Plus, Silver is a ugly character. Who would want to date him?
Okay, I know you hate Silver, but that's really offensive to me because, I may not be a fictional character, but if I was, I would date that hottie boy any day. But that's not the story.
Alright, one thing that's always confused me, and I need somebody to answer this question, preferably Sonic93. Everybody has their fictional crushes and all that stuff, you know. When I was younger, it was Sonic. Now it's Kylo Ren or Darth Maul. But I remember your video about Yoshiri 1. Well, the pop culture gamer as I knew him before on Tumblr. I don't know what he goes by now, but yeah, I'm I don't know. I'm not going to call him Yoshimi One. I'm going to call him the pop culture gamer because that's what he was. So you got on him about how he found certain women hot. And you said, like, when he found, like, Jane Reed hot from Arthur. And you were like, you know, find girls that are appropriate and in your age. However, you know, and I know you aged up Silver, but Silver is, like, canonically 14, and you're like, I would date him any day, and you talk about how you find him sexy, but the pop culture gamer is not allowed to find a mom hot, but yet you're allowed to find a canonically 14-year-old character hot. I'm not trying to say that, you know, you like young kids. I'm not trying to say that at all. I'm just saying, you know, you got on a guy for liking a character that's not in their age range. However, it's totally okay for you to do the same thing with Silver. Why is that? What makes you so different? You know, I just generally, I don't know. Like I said, you are allowed to want to have a crush on whoever you want. I have a crush on Kylo Ren and Darth Maul. I just don't understand that. You know, why is it okay for you to like certain characters, but not okay for the people you ranted on? Just answer me that.
I literally ranted on this whole video just for saying things I disliked about Silver. This video was bothering me for months because she was saying how I was shallow and a faker just for saying one comment on DA about Silver being poorly portrayed in 06 along with his voice. Everyone has the right to like and dislike traits of a fictional Sonic character, and it feels that if someone states what they hate about a character, they get bashed for it. Why don't people realize that they're just fictional, not real, just 3D graphics or drawing made by artists?
I mean, she has a point, you know? Why can't you accept that, you know, people have different opinions, and not just that, why can't you accept that these characters are fictional? They're fictional pixels on a screen. They're just ones and zeros floating in an endless cyberspace. They're not real. They're not something that you should get worked up over. Like, say it with me. Silver is not real. Say it again. Silver is not real.
Speaking of that, are you even a 15-year-old girl? Because I saw you say that you're almost 17 years old! Like a year later, you stated that you're 15! Melody! Can't you count? Where's the number 16 in your age timeline?
Gather around, kiddos. It's time for Rey Skywalker-Ren's Math Corner! Now, Sonic93 doesn't understand why a year ago Melody says, oh, less than a year ago Melody says she was turning 17, while more than a year ago she was 15. Okay, how about this? Maybe within that year she was turning 16, but she was 15, and now she's almost 17. So it's kind of easy to see where the number 16 fits in. She was currently 16 when she said she was turning 17 or she was almost 17. But I'll be honest with you, I don't understand why we're nitpicking her age. But her age is very important to talk about in this case, and I'm going to kind of go into a little bit of a spiel here. Now, for example, a lot of us are adults, right? You know, if some edgelord on the internet criticize us and how we like the character, most of us wouldn't really care. You know, some of us might make rant videos, some of us might make journals, some of us might, you know, parade it on Tumblr and show it to our friends and go, ha ha ha, look at this person getting upset at my opinion. You know, right? But, you know, with someone like Melody who is 16 or almost 17, you know, it's different because this is still a child. You know, this is a teenager, and the one thing about teenagers is that their brain is not fully developed. The part of their brain that controls, like, emotions and critical thinking, that's not fully developed yet. So, she can't really process, you know, people being mean to her like that, like an adult would. So of course she's gonna lash out in a way that's less than satisfactory, you know, or less than savory, you know, because she doesn't know better. This girl does not know better. She doesn't know how to really channel her emotions. So, and the thing is about with kids is that kids are easily influenced by adults. Sonic 93 is a 26-year-old woman with almost a million followers on YouTube. And Melody was almost only a 15-year-old girl on DeviantArt with an opinion who didn't really have a lot of followers. So therefore, I can clearly see how she was affected by this video and how her opinions have changed and her behavior. You know, I've seen a lot of her posts that she acts like, you know, she can be a really, she could be a little bit of an edgelord and she could be trollish. And she can also, like, you know, act in a way that Sonic 93 is acting right now. But it's not that hard to connect the video that Sonic 93 made to Melody's behavior now and her age. You know, this is why I am, like, upset with the video. Because you just kind of damaged this teenage girl. And you should really feel ashamed of yourself. Spiel over. Alright, so I had to skip over the last part of this video because it was mainly her making fun of Melody when she was kind of in the edgelord state, but it was because of her video, and Sonic 93 doesn't get it, and blah blah blah, so we're gonna skip over this part, and we're gonna deem this video as done. Alright, so we are finally done with this video. Now, what have we learned? Well, we learned that despite the apology video, Sonic 93 hasn't learned a darn thing. We also learned that she's still gatekeeping, even though she doesn't know what that means. You know, she's being protective of her precious male hedgehog. And that she's also shallow as well. Now, like I said many times, I used to be this way with Sonic. I used to be that edgy, you know, edgy edgelord on the internet who, you know, would put Sonic on a high pedestal. Anyone on Sonic Stadium can tell you that. You know, I was the infamous person. And a little bit of a history. When I first joined Sonic Stadium, my name was Sonic. It was Sonic's Japanese name. And I was somebody who didn't know much English. And I know it's hard to believe because I can speak perfectly now, but I had to work really hard at it for the past 9 years. But yeah, I was a huge fan of Sonic the character, and it got to the point where it was cute at first, and then it was so cringy. Reading my old post there, I am so mortified because I was so cringy. And like, I would put him on a pedestal, I would lie about other characters, I wouldn't accept criticism of Sonic. It was the whole thing. And looking back at it now, you know, I wish that I wouldn't have been that way. And then I had to learn the hard way and then I tried to change my opinions drastically so that I can be popular, and it's just a whole nother can of worms. But I'm going to be focusing on the fangirl part. So, my final thoughts. Sonic 93, from one fangirl to another, or a former, you know, fan brat to another, you know, please understand that what you're doing is wrong. I hope that this video can help you. You know, I just want to help. You know, I haven't really made a lot of sarcastic jokes. I mean, yeah, I was a little bit sassy, but, you know, I haven't really insulted you or belittled you. I mean, at least I didn't. If I did, feel free to tell me. You know, I am more than happy to admit that I am wrong. You know, but the purpose of this video is to help you. And because I went through the same thing that you're going through now, I can resonate with you. So I hope this video finds you in time. Well, The rest is up to you now. See you later. Till the spire.